Okay. But positive attitude is important. What do you mean by attitude? We always talk about positive attitude. What would you think an attitude is? Positive attitude? What is an attitude? The first letter is, what is attitude? The way you look at things. The way you look. It's very simple. The way you look at things. How you feel about what you see, or how you feel about what you know. Yeah? And now we come to positive attitude is one which sees the brighter sides of things, or you call count your blessings or whatever you want to say. And a negative attitude is which focuses on the shortcomings, the failures. It's not that a person with positive attitude is not aware of the negative things, but his focus is on the positive thing. Whereas a negative person, say even a job, etc., his focus is all the time on what is not good about a situation, rather than what is good about a situation. I'll tell you one small story. So I think you must have all read or heard about it. Leading psychologist of Stanford University conducted a small study of two small children, 8 years, 7 years, two boys. They took one boy and put him in a room like this, big room, in which there were all wonderful, colorful toys. And they said, we are going to leave you half an hour here, and you can, these toys are all yours, and you can do whatever you want to do. And they locked the door and went, thinking that when they come back, they will find this boy playing, enjoying himself, doing things, etc. The other boy, they took him to a similar room, okay? And in that room, there was nothing but horse manure, or to use it colloquially, shit. It was full of manure, horse manure. And they thought that this boy will start grumbling and crying, etc. They locked him up also. After half an hour, when they went and opened the first room, where the wonderful toys were there, they were shocked to see that the boy is crying, is weeping, is whining and doing all sorts of things. They said, what has happened? Some wonderful toys and all. And he started. No, the elastic of this is not working. This color I don't like. This is too big. This is too small. This doesn't function well. All sorts of things he cried, and he didn't enjoy his half an hour with it. They didn't say anything. They left him and went. And they went to the other room thinking that boy will be crying. And when they went, they found that boy is throwing this manure and laughing and jumping and enthusiastically playing about and enjoying himself thoroughly. They were shocked that a boy can do that. So they asked him, we left you with so much of horse manure and we thought we would find you crying, but you are enjoying yourself thoroughly. What's the secret? And this is the boy's answer. He said, with so much of horse shit around, I was sure there will be some pony somewhere. You got the point? Yeah, so the expression in English is, look for the pony in everything. Please write this down. Look for the pony in everything. In every situation, see where the pony is. Okay. So we have covered these 4 points. Then a few other things are very simple. A winner is always conscious of his time. He knows the time is the most precious resource. And if your life is made of time, and if you waste time, you're wasting life. So he is very clear about his priorities, and he manages his time well. We'll come to that. In fact, confidence is the beginning and the blossoming of all this. If you develop all these qualities, self-confidence will be the result. Competence is one of the qualities. Definitely competence is. So time management is important for a winner. He always manages his time well. I'm conscious of the time. There's still time. Another 15 minutes to go. I will complete it. I promise. In this world, people who communicate well get rewards far in excess of what they deserve. Do you agree with me? In a college also, the boy or girl who communicates well gets all the glory and the fame and in corporate life also. And top bosses generally are good communicators. People at the top generally are good communicators. So the winner takes trouble to become a good communicator, to become an effective communicator, to be able to talk one-to-one, one-to-many, because he has to talk to people. So effective communication is another quality of a winner. Communication includes listening skills. Listening is the very important but a very neglected aspect of communication. In fact, an OIO study of executives and winners showed that an average executive spends only 9% of his time in writing, 16% of his time in reading, and 30% of his time in speaking. And where does the remaining 45% go? Listening. And the higher you go up, the more you have to listen. Unfortunately, listening is not being emphasized. But all winners are good listeners. You know, a decision maker who does not listen well does not have all the information. A decision maker who listens well has more information also. So, effective communication is important. Time manage is over. Two more. Yeah. Team player. Okay. You are coming to that. He maintains good human relations. A winner knows that he cannot go it alone. Particularly in the corporate world, dealing in a business world, etc. A Tiger Woods can go alone. Or an M.F. Hussain can go alone. Or an Andre Agassi can go alone. They don't fall into this stereotype of winners because they are self-actualized human beings. You see? But Dhoni has to be a good human relation man because he's leading a team. So, if there's one quality, as Henry Ford said, for which I would pay more than for any other quality, it is his ability to get along with people. Ability to get along with people. Winners develop this ability to get along with people. And they maintain good human relations with people. You know, in this world, if everything was smooth and easy, there would be no problem. Everybody was kind to you, everybody was cooperative, everybody was nice. But you drive your car and somebody, you wait in the bus queue and somebody comes from behind and takes it, okay? And those of you who are married, you know. Okay. Right. Now, in many situations, are very irksome, challenging, yes, but in not a very pleasant way, you know, unfavorable circumstances, not in a very pleasant way. Situations like you want something and somebody will come and you knock you on the train, somebody pushes you and things like that. Now in such situations, people react generally in three ways. One is the passive way. What does a passive person do? He allows people to ride roughshod over him. He cannot speak up for himself. He suffers and he tries to give big philosophy. In the next world, get reward for this, etc. The thing is, he's actually unhappy with himself that he cannot face that situation. He can't tell somebody to shut up or whatever it is. So, a passive person is not meant to be a winner. Because a passive person is a slave to his fears. On the other hand, you have an aggressive person who asserts his rights, but he does it so forcefully, appropriately, that he trips on the feet of others. He violates other people's rights. He's not sensitive to other people's feelings and sufferings, etc. He rides roughshod over them. Now, aggressive person also will not be a success for long. An aggressive person is a slave to his anger. Now, in between, you have what is known as an assertive person.
Balance.
A winner is an assertive person. He can speak openly, directly, genuinely to others, being in harmony with his own self-esteem and at the same time respecting the other person. He can say no when he has to say no without feeling anything. Okay. So assertiveness is another quality of winners, because if you have to manage your time, one of the qualities you need is you have to be assertive. Otherwise, you'll keep on saying yes to so many superficial demands, so many superficial activities, superfluous activities, etc. So, a winner develops assertiveness. Winner is assertive. Okay. One thing we didn't mention, I asked you, one important quality which all winners take care of is their health. Don't forget, health is primary. If you're healthy, you'll be enthusiastic and energy. A winner takes care of his health with a regimen of diet, exercise, etc. He doesn't have to be a bodybuilder or something, but yes. If he has to work 18 hours, 20 hours a day, he does take care of his body with adequate relaxation also. Now we come to what sees of Venus personality. The first one is clarity. I'll come to your competence next. Clarity. The essence of clarity is knowing where you are and where you want to go. Where you are and where you want to go. A Venus is very clear about